Hey, today we are going to talk about a counter deck to Tenpai because there are so many of them right now. This is a Earthbound Runic. The basis of this deck is we rely on 3-card combo. The basic is we use a Nightmare Art Theme to summon 3 tokens to opponent's field. And then we use Rollback to copy Earthbound release effect. This effect is when a level 6 or higher is normal special summon tribute. We can ignore the tribute because we are dodging the Earthbound monster cost by using rollback. So this will destroy the 3 tokens that we summon and inflict damage equal to the attack. Each of them has 2000 attack, which means it's 6000 damage. The monster summoned by this effect, if it dies, the controller takes 800 damage each. Combining 6000 and then 800 times 3 will be 8400 damage. And that's lethal. So that's the basic. There are a few things that we can help. Normally, we want Earthbound and Transaction Rollback in the graveyard. However, we can skip one of the requirements by using Junk Collector. So Junk Collector effect is we can banish this card and one of the traps from the graveyard and copy the effect. For example, if we copy Nightmare Art Theme, we no longer need to tribute one monster. This dodges the effect. This is also useful when you milk your Art Theme to the graveyard because we no longer trigger this on field effect, so we can copy the effect to summon the tokens. That's one of the things. Second thing is if we have no rollback in the graveyard but we have like Earthbound, we can also use a Junk Collector to copy Earthbound effect. The important thing to know is that this is a one effect, so the last thing resolved, whether there was a chain or not, has to be the summoned effect, the level 6 summon effect. So which means if we are setting starting a chain, this has to be chain link 1. If opponent if they trigger something, you do not want to chain this if you want to OTK. Wait for them finish their resolution and then start chain link 1 on this. Because this means they chain link 2 maxi and then they chain link 3. Ash their own maxi for whatever reason. Ash will resolve first and then maxi resolve second. This will be the last, because this is a chain link 1, this will be the last thing that resolve. So this will satisfy the one went condition. So this is one more thing important to note. More things to help us to satisfy these conditions is first thing is a trap chick. We can banish one normal trap and then set another trap with the same name. We can trigger this trap, the set trap, on the same turn that it sets. However, after resolution of this card, we can only trigger one trap card for the rest of this turn. So keep in mind of this restriction. So normally what happens is you want to copy this. You want to either set Arc Theme on the field so you can summon tokens, or you can set Palio. Palio effect is we can send the trap. If we have one of these in the graveyard but we are missing the other one, we can use Palio to send that to the graveyard. Or if you have Junk Collector, you can choose to send Arc Theme. That's one of the thing. One thing to know is the Arc Theme effect, if you have activating on field, it requires a tribute. So you get a tribute, like it's pretty easy to get a tribute in this deck because we have runic house. Every single runic spell gives you a monster. So that would be considered as tribute. Or if we have a Palio in the grave, we can able to summon it back if there's a trap card that's activated. So a trap card that's activated is only counted if it's activated on the field. So if you have a trap card like rollback triggered in the graveyard, it does not count it as a trap card activation. So that's another restriction to keep in mind. Runic Engine is mostly there to summon bodies to the field, or we can use it as a jaw engine. However, this is not mandatory, which means when we are playing against Tenpai, we want to trigger runic effect. For example, we can summon Hugin and use Hugin to search for field. They most likely gonna have some form of negate, because they run in so many hand traps. So you want to bait the negate using the runic effect, because well, mostly like they will fall for that bait, because in the beginning they're gonna think that assume that you are a runic player and they want to stop the field. And after that you can do whatever remains. I'm using tombs because remember we want these cards to be in the graveyard. So we can send them using to the graveyard, or we can send them using a runic Hugin as a cost. And last thing we can send is using Into the Void if we happen to draw this in hand. And the reason why you want to bait using runic is this reasoning and monster gate, you want to prioritize having these spells to pass, because you want to milk your graveyard. You want to bait negate first and then trigger these things. Okay, and then next thing is Jack Synchro. These two will summon a monster. The only two monsters that can be normal summon or set is these two. So the rest are all milk. There's a very good chance that you will milk like half of your deck before you hitting one of these cards. One thing to know is that Jack Synchro has two effects. The first effect is you can dump a card. When it's in the graveyard, you can dump a card from your hand to special summon this. And then the second effect is when this leaves the field, you can search for junk collector. Important to know is that this is you can only use one of the effects one turn. So you have to debate between the when you want to use which effect. For example, this I will showcase in the replay later. This deck we also run Goyo Defender, and this is mostly to link climb all the way to Skull Dread. So how you gonna do this is first you summon for example Hugin, and then you get John Synchro into the field, and then you summon Goyo. Goyo will able to duplicate itself. So you and then duplicate second Goyo duplicate the third Goyo. So at the end you have three Goyo. Because if you triggered Jack Synchro from the graveyard, it will go to banish, which means we can have two Goyo to exist into Sea Dragon, which lets us to summon the banished Jack Synchro back to the deck. And then lastly, you either link away the Jack Synchro with this, or you make it into Goyo. And then the fourth monster is you can use either of the runic cards as the fourth monsters. So now you have four different monsters with different names. This will enable the fourth effect, which lets us draw four cards and then place three cards from the back to the deck in any order. This is useful if they negated you and then you need that additional draw power. So you basically most likely you want to search for either of these to milk your deck more. So this is the basics. One more thing to know is that if you read the first sentence, it's level 6 or more is summoned. So it does not have to be triggered by Nightmare Fiend effect. You can trigger this by summoning your own Mighty Lake Horse. This is a level 9. This will also satisfy a bound effect. So for whatever reason you're not able to make tokens and opponent just keep comboing, they usually don't know about all these tricks. So if you have this in your graveyard, or you have this our opponent turn, when they summon monsters with combined attack to be 8,000 or more, or depending whatever their life point is, you can then summon many lake horse, and then that will satisfy a bound condition. So you can do this also as a one turn kill. One more thing is if you want to like make sure this combo 100% pass, you can also use Mighty Lake Horse plus Jack Synchro to make Brawn. So you will see in the video we make the Omni Negate to protect our OD gate. That's the how to play this deck. I will also, I will live stream and test more Tenpai counter decks. So be sure to like and subscribe. And thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.